Hey everyone, I'm Vikram Salunkhe and welcome to the x86 assembly. In this video, we will continue our conversion from C to assembly. We will only see half of the program. The other half of this program we will see in the next video. The thing we are going to see is main is calling function 1, function 1 is calling function 2, and function 2 is calling function 3. Now we are in Visual Studio. We will see the execution of an instruction, changes in registers, and modification of stack. We are executing from the main. First instruction is push EBP. EBP is 0012FFB8. That is a function stack frame pointer who called main. Step into that. It got pushed onto the stack. After that, we are moving ESP into the EBP. ESP is 0012FF68. That means from this point, main stack frame will begin. Step into that. Okay, we have moved ESP into the EBP. Okay, now the next instruction is call function 1. For that, what we will do, we will copy next instruction's address onto the stack. Then we will pass control to the function 1. Why we are copying the next instruction's address onto the stack? Because when function 1 finishes its execution, it can pop that address and it can return to the main. Let's execute that instruction. As we can see, next instruction address got pushed onto the stack and now we are in function 1. Let's see the same thing in an animation format. This is the same thing. We are executing from the main and EIP is pointing to the push EBP. EBP is 0012FFB8 that will get pushed onto the stack. After that, next instruction is move ESP into the EBP because from this point it will be a main stack frame. Okay, ESP has been moved into the EBP. Next C program statement is we are calling function 1 and its assembly equivalent is call function 1. For that, what we will do, we will push next instruction's address onto the stack because using that address, EIP can return to the main. And now we will pass control to the function 1. We are in function 1. First instruction is push EBP. We are pushing the stack frame pointer of a main onto the stack. Step onto that. It got pushed. After that, we are moving ESP into EBP because we want to start function 1 stack frame onto the stack. Let's step into that. Okay, so 0012FF60 that got moved into the EBP. Okay, next instruction is we are calling function 2. For that, we will push next instruction address onto the stack because using that address, EIP can return to function 1. Let's execute that. And as we can see, we have passed control to the function 2 and next instruction address is onto the stack. Let's see the same thing in an animation format for a better understanding. We are executing from function 1. First instruction is push EBP. Our EBP is 0012FF68. That will get pushed onto the stack. After that, ESP will move into the EBP to start the function 1 stack frame onto the stack. Let's execute that instruction. Okay, so ESP got moved into the EBP. Next C program segment is we are calling function 2 and its assembly equivalent is call function 2. For that, we will move next instruction address onto the stack. So using that address, EIP can return to function 1 and we are passing control to the function 2. Now we are in function 2. First, we are pushing EBP onto the stack and EBP contains function 1's stack frame pointer. Let's step into that. It got pushed onto the stack. After that, we are moving ESP into the EBP because we want to start function 2's stack frame onto the stack. Step into that. Okay, now ESP got moved into the EBP. Next, we are calling function 3. For that, we will move next instruction's address onto the stack. So EIP can return to the function 2 after finishing execution from function 3. Step into that and it got pushed onto the stack, and now we are executing from function 3. Let's see the same thing in an animation format. We are executing from function 2. First instruction is push EBP. EBP is 0012FF60 and that will get pushed onto the stack. Next instruction is move ESP into the EBP. That means ESP 0012FF58 will get moved into the EBP to start function 2 stack frame. Next C statement is we are calling function 3. An assembly equivalent for that is for call function 3. For that, we will push next instruction's address onto the stack. It got pushed onto the stack and we are passing control to function 3. Now we are in function 3. The first instruction is push EBP. We are pushing the old stack frame pointer, that is function 2 stack frame pointer, onto the stack. Step into that. Next, move ESP into the EBP. That means ESP 0012FF50 will be moved into the EBP to start function 3 stack frame onto the stack. Step into that. After that, the next C statement is we are returning with the 3s. For that, first we will copy 3s into the EAX. Let's step into that. And now as we can see, the 3s are into the EAX. See the same thing in an animation format. We are executing from function 3. First instruction is push EBP. Our EBP is 0012FF58. That will get pushed onto the stack. Next instruction is move ESP into the EBP. ESP 0012FF50 will be moved into the EBP to start function 3 stack frame onto the stack. It got moved. Next C statement is we are returning with the 3s. For that, what we will do, we will move 3s into the EAX. We moved 3 into the EAX. Now let's look at our stack. This is our stack and this is function 3 stack frame. This is function 2 stack frame. This is function 1 stack frame. This is main stack frame and this is the initialization function stack frame who called main. So this is how our stack is looking right now. So that's it for this video. The remaining part we will see in the next video. So stay tuned. Thank you.